Good afternoon, students. I would like to greet you this afternoon and introduce myself to you. I know you have seen my names online, but this time you're going to hear my voice. Today's short video will be an introduction or orientation to reflective teaching in grade R. Our module code is RTG1501. As I said, this is a module in induction or orientation. My name is Dr. Manyaka. I'm a lecturer at Early Childhood Education, and RTG1501 is one of my modules. Here's my picture, but I'm hoping that one day we will have a session where we'll be able to see each other through the video and discuss so that we get to know each other better. My presentation content is an introduction to the module. I'm going to explain also how we need to communicate. I'm going to talk about the purpose of the module. Then I'm going to look at the module level and expectations, and then the module outcome, then we conclude. How should I communicate with you? Not them, I'll correct that. You can contact your lecturer through a telephone. If the need arises, I will create a WhatsApp so that because you are not such a large group, we could be able to have a WhatsApp and communicate easier. But when you communicate, you should write email. Make sure that you use my life email. The university only allows us to use the official emails. In your case, it's my life email. And if you use a private email, we don't respond. We have also created discussion forums, and for that, we expect you to engage. I already created one where I said you should get to know each other, because some of you ask us if we should form a Telegram. We don't do that, but when you are on the discussion forum, you get to know other students, maybe even others that are within your area, where you can be able to discuss some of the modules together. Now, what is the purpose of this module? Reflective teaching in grade R. The main purpose is for you as students. When you say for students, we mean you, to understand complexities of teaching grade R. We say it's complex in the sense that this is a grade whereby we are laying a foundation, and it has got different approaches from formal classrooms. For instance, we'll have play-based teaching. There will be outdoor play, indoor. Others, they are formal. Others, they've been planned. It's a very special grade. I won't say it's complex. For me, it's complex. I think it's special in that that's where you are able to teach learners according to their age. We call it age appropriateness, but it lays a foundation that will sort of dictate how they're going to learn going forward. We examine teaching techniques, routines. When you talk about routines, you can immediately think of the routines that take place in grade R. As they come in, it's different. They don't just go and get to their desks. There are routines that are followed, and they're usually linked to the subject matter as well, and they learn in that case. And subjects in the curriculum, including assessment in grade R. Already, I'm happy that you know grade R classrooms, because this is your diploma and you are already in the field. So you do understand most of the things. I don't see a reason why you don't get a distinction. Identify the complexities of teaching grade R in different contexts with children of varying abilities. This is a loaded statement. We are talking about different contexts. When you talk about different contexts, it means that not all learners are within the same environment. The context will be different. And also the abilities are not the same. Some learners are quick to understand. Others, they are just average. Others, they need support. And these days, we don't call them slow learners. They learn properly. It's just that they need more support. So you should be able to identify those learners and also make sure that you understand the context at which they are. Don't go to a rural area and then you start asking learners about the Gautrain. Even if it's another, it's in Kimberley, it might be in town, but they don't have a Gautrain. They might have a different train. Meaning that you understand the context where your grade R is. You need to have the ability to be empowered, to be able to approach learners based on their different context. Also, this module will assist you as qualifying students in creating and using evidence for a variety of purposes for different stakeholders. Even the parents are stakeholders, by the way. Now, how do we build your competence in this module? To start with, you need to understand the module outcomes. You need to understand, what is this module for? What is it expected in this module? Then you must do a work plan. Look at the module outcomes and then draw your own work plan. If there are four, you must know, how do I spread them? So spread my work in a way that when I submit my assignment, I've covered all the work. And also you look at the preparing for exam. You must give yourself enough time. Don't just wait for the last minute and say, I'll submit an assessment a night before. Others, even they're differing in the time that they are due. Though maybe the due date might be on that day, you might find that it closes at 4 o'clock. So don't wait for disappointments. Plan through your work plan so that at the end you are able to submit in time. Also give yourself time to prepare for exam. And then we also guide you through towards your competencies towards responding to assessments at the required level. We've got what we call Bloom's taxonomy. I take it you are not hearing about it for the first time. This is levels of understanding, levels of demand in your cognitive level, cognitive meaning in your thinking. There would be that level whereby, according to this table, it means at level 1 or 2, we are not demanding much. We are just saying, remember, you just have to remember to choose, to define, to get questions like how, to list, to name, and to label. That's at the very basic. But however, just remember that your module is an NQF level 5. Here, for remembering, because you are writing online and you have access to a study guide, it was supposed to be 40% of the questions were supposed to come here, but we are only going to limit to 20, so that we recognize that we want you to be able to think deeper because you have access to the study guide or study material. Then when it gets to the middle order, 40%, there are examples of verbs here. At middle order, we are expected to apply, to build, to develop, to identify, to organize, to plan and compare. There are many, many, many other verbs. This is just an example. These are the verbs that we'll use when we ask questions. Higher order is going to be also 40%. It means it's 20, 40, 40 to make 100. Here we are going to expect deeper thinking, to compare, to interpret, to justify, to elaborate. So you might be having a study guide there, but we still want you to think critically, to be able to voice your opinion, to be able to criticize. So this is what we expect of you. Module outcomes, I said, when you talk about the module outcomes, what is it that is expected for a person to, where we can say this person has passed this module? The first specific outcome is you should be able to discuss the concepts of reflective teaching. How do we test that? On the right-hand side, we call this assessment criteria. In other words, we are going to use this criteria, this all this that's written here, to test if you are able, you can discuss this the reflective teaching with confidence. You should be able to define it. You should be able to understand reflective teaching in relation to reflection in action or reflection on action. And then also you should be able to discuss the importance of reflective teaching and be able to explain it. The models for reflective teachings are analyzed and you look at how it is relevant to grade A. Also, you learn strategies to develop an evidence-informed grade R classrooms where those are engaged with relation to children with varying abilities. I've already spoken about abilities. And then you should also be able to have a journal where you are able to document examples of reflective teaching. Even if they were to ask you to go look at your peer, the fellow teacher, you should be able to say, I saw, reflect, allow them to reflect and analyze their reflection, and then you'll be able to see barriers or the successes. The second one, you've developed techniques that enable reflective teaching in grade R program. How are we going to do that? We're going to assess if you are able to use techniques that encourage reflective teaching. You are able to identify them and then discuss them. You should be able to analyze a grade R timetable for application. You must be able to apply it, analyze it so that you see, can this be applied? Can it work in my situation? You must be able to also to understand techniques through engagement with reflection in action. We'll talk about reflection in action. We are also going to discuss the technique of reflection on action. You should be able to differentiate that. And then the third one, examine case studies using reflective teaching in routines and subjects in the grade R program. Here you need to reflect on different in different geographical context. What does that mean? It means that when you find yourself in a context that is rural, you should be able to reflect on your approaches and techniques, understanding the context that it is different. And also if a person is in township or in town, in urban areas, sometimes even urban areas are different. You cannot teach a learner in Kimberley or in a town in Limpopo, let's say Zanino, Palabora, and expect them to know how to train. Then you put it there and you want them to identify it as your prior knowledge. You can't, because the context is different. The jigs of the matter is you need to understand that different setting need different approaches, and the learners are also different. Critical incidents that require reflection are identified and analyzed. If there's an incident in the classroom, maybe you came thinking that you're going to bring a certain play activity that will be able to give a certain outcome, but when you get into the classroom, it doesn't. Or there's an incident that made you to pause and say, and what is this? So you should be able to criticize or to analyze that incident and reflect on it and make sure that you are able to gain something out of it. The action from reflection is engaged in order to support learning children with varying abilities. And then the strength and areas of concern using a reflective teaching approach in a context are also identified. Sorry, this was cut. identified and discussed. The last one, you use feedback from your reflection, reflective teaching, or your own reflection, and you are able to feed forward, to plan forward, to support learning in grade R program. Don't be reactionary, only act when you see things are not working. You must plan forward. Come with a scenario, think of a scenario, and then say, should I use this approach? What is it that will be done in the classroom? What will be the outcome? And then you are able to visualize in retrospect of what you have experienced, and you visualize, you apply going forward. And you should be able to give feedback for different target groups, for yourself, for learners, for parents, so that you can also identify early intervention support staff, that the early interventions that are needed, so you are able to give feedback to the early intervention support staff that should be planned and engaged with. Also, as a teacher, you must know that according to inclusivity, the white paper 6, you should be able to identify learners that have challenges, and you must first do your reflection, apply different technologies, and after that, if you still realize that this learner needs a support, then you follow the school processes for the learner. But you start with reflecting on what you see, and then you plan forward, you apply, you critique yourself in what you are doing, not that you are negative, but you see if there's nothing better that you can do. And if all that fails, then you are able to bring the third party. Improvement of plans for specific groups and be able to develop them. Thank you. This is just a short orientation. This module is very short, but very interesting. As you read it, keep on reflecting on what you are doing in the classroom. Going forward, as I said, this is just an orientation. Now we understand what the module is all about. We know the specific outcomes. We know the criteria that are going to be used. We know the NQF level that you need to think that maybe only 20% will require me to remember. The rest, I must be able to think deeper. Middle order is 40%, which is level 3 and 4, and the other one is level 5 and 6. Once you have that understanding, as we move forward, and when I post some videos for you to think about, you should be able to, at the back of your mind, say, if they were to give me this case study, I must know that I'm not going to get just questions that want me to explain how, to name, to list. It will be deeper. So I would like to thank you and wish you the best. And we will be on this journey together. Thank you.